NRF51 and 52 series of ICs are microcontrollers with built-in Bluetooth radio made by Nordic Semiconductor. They are very popular system on chips used in many smartbands, smartwatches and other simple Bluetooth devices. In addition to such devices sold to end users, NRF51 and 52 chip can also be found on some wireless modules intended to be used with another microcontrollers. But there are also cheap development ports from Nordic Semiconductor and other manufacturers as well. For simple projects where few GPIOs is enough, I like these NRF51 modules. These are small, easy to work with, and at least when I bought these were the cheapest NRF51 modules. Originally these are controlled with AT commands, but I like to write my own firmware on these. For simple projects, I like to do it in Arduino IDE. For the project I'm using as a demonstration in this video, I designed a board with OLED and some push buttons. The PCBs came from the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com is an affordable PCB manufacturer who offers PCBs starting from just $5 plus shipping for 10 two-layer 100x100mm PCBs. They are a great PCB manufacturer for all your prototyping and low-volume production needs. If you need something else than just usual two-layer boards with usual green solder mask, head over to PCBWay.com, check their capabilities and check out all the different options you have during the ordering process. Nordic Semiconductor has SDK available for these chips to take full advantage of all the features these chips have to offer, and for the best support, that SDK is recommended way to program these. But there's a learning curve, and many users want to program their microcontrollers using the trusty old Arduino IDE. So far, I have used only Arduino IDE to program NRF51 chips, and I would like to show you how to set up the Arduino IDE for these NRF51 or 52 chips. What is the cheapest programmer for them, and what library can be used for creating your own BLE peripherals? Lucky for hobbyists working with low budget, there are cheap Chinese ST-Link clones like this, which can also be used to flash the NRF5 chips. The Arduino add-on that provides support for NRF5 chips supports the ST-Link as a hardware programmer, and connecting 3.3V ground, data and clock is all that is needed in addition to selecting ST-Link in the Arduino menu. There are a few Arduino compatible NRF5 based boards out there, and for specific boards, the vendor may have their resources for making those specific boards work with Arduino IDE. But for generic boards, I have found the easiest way to make them work is to use the resources made by Sandeep Mistry. Links are in the description. Put the link to additional board manager URLs section in the Arduino IDE. Restart the IDE and use the board manager to install the Nordic Semiconductor NRF5 ports support. In order to create BLE peripherals, also install BLE peripheral library using the library manager. When installing new ports or libraries, it's a good idea to restart the IDE. Now when I go to Tools, Port menu in the IDE, there are multiple NRF5 based ports to choose from. Because my port isn't on that list, I will select generic NRF51. There are different memory variations of this chip, so I need to see if my chip has marking AA or AC, and select the correct chip according to the markings. One more thing to do is flashing the soft device to the chip. Soft device on Nordic chip is pre-compiled binary provided by Nordic, including the wireless protocol stack. Different versions allow doing different things. For example, S110 allows making BLE peripherals using NRF51 822, while S130 allows making BLE devices that are both peripheral and central. So, depends on what you are making, you can use one or the other. S130 uses more memory, which is why you may want to go with S110 if possible. Once all those selections have been made, run NRF5 flash soft device in IDE's tools menu. That's it. Now Arduino IDE can be used to program NRF51 and 52 boards. Most basic things work just as they do with other Arduino compatible boards. For BLE projects, there are multiple examples that comes with the BLE peripheral library. Browsing those is a good idea if you want to start creating your own BLE peripherals. I want to keep this video as an just introduction and just as a simple tutorial on setting up the environment. BLE projects may come in the future. By the way, for some reason the HID examples don't work with Windows 10. I don't know why, I don't know how to fix that. In addition to BLE, there's one special thing that is luxury for anyone upgrading from 18MHz to 8B based Arduinos. That is, you can use any pins as I2C pins. Use whatever pins you find most suitable in your case. In the sketch, inside setup, run wire.setpins with SDA pin number as first parameter and SCL pin as second parameter. Here I am testing Adafruit's SSD1306 library's example as a demonstration. This board is kind of a helper project, helping me to test the installation of NRF5 add-on on the Arduino IDE and possibly helping development of future BLE projects. The setup process was the main part of this video, but the board files and the schematic of this PCB will still be available. If you have any cool ideas to make with these NRF chips, share them with others in the comment section. Maybe I or someone else will pick it up and make a project out of it. If you have any questions or problems with this installation, leave a comment below and maybe we can solve the problems together. Also, if you are familiar with this setup, help others if you find unsolved problems in the comment section. Thanks. Bye.